Hey guys, it's David from mdbootstrap.com. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to start building web application using Python, and we're gonna use one of the most famous framework, which is Django. So without further ado, let's get started. Now, in order to start, we have to download Python first. So navigate to python.org and download the newest version for your platform. In my case, it's Windows. Run the installer. Please remember to mark this add Python to path. That's going to be very helpful. And proceed with the installation. You can use the default values, but obviously, if you want to go with more advanced setup, you can customize your installation options. Once installation is complete, you can close installer window, and now we're gonna verify whether Python has been successfully installed on our operating system. In order to do so, let's open a terminal. In my case, it's gonna be command line and type python minus minus version. You should see the current version of Python in the window. Now it's high time to install Django, so search for Django in Google and navigate to project page or go directly to djangoproject.com. Click on Get Started with Django, Django Installation Guide, and find Install an Official Release. In order to install Django, we need pip. So let's go to link in the documentation. You're gonna find this also in the description to this video, and choose the command line for your platform. Copy the code and paste it in the terminal or type it directly. First, we're gonna download pip. So we're gonna use curl option. That's gonna download installer. And now we're gonna run it by running py getpip.py. This will install pip. Now let's get back to Django documentation. Then again, choose your platform. In my case, it's Windows. Copy the code or command and run it. In my case, it's py-m pip install Django. This will install Django globally on our computer. Okay, so now we are ready to start our development. So let's navigate to folder of our choice. Now open it in editor of your choice. I'm gonna use Visual Studio Code. And I'm also gonna use the command line over here. So let's start with checking whether our Django has been installed correctly. In order to do so, let's type python minus m Django minus minus version, and this will show us 3.1.4, which is the newest one at this very moment when I'm creating this video. So now let's create a new project. So in order to do so, let's type Django dash admin start project, and let's call it my site. This will create directory over here. Now, let's have a look at the project structure. So you have a couple of files over here. We're gonna go through them in the next videos, next tutorials, which are more advanced. For now, for you to remember is that this is our project. Now, let's start our server. So you have to know that Python has built-in server. So type Python, manage the py, run server. And now, as you can see, we are getting error, and this is because I tried to run this command in a top level folder, and in order to do so, we have to enter this my site folder. So let's navigate there, cd my site, and now let's run command again, and this will start our server. You can see in the console that everything went fine, and this will show us our starting page. So as you can see, this is a debug version of our page, and we can see all this data over here because we have this debug set to true, but we're not gonna focus on that for now. Let's continue, and now let's create an app. So we already created a project, so this is our my site project, and now we're gonna create and app. So what you have to know is that project is something bigger than app. So you can think of it like a project can be your website with your blog and e-commerce and so on. And ideally, you should split your project into smaller apps. So you can have app like a blog app, you can have like a, you know, shop app, you can have your cart app, checkout app, and so on. So the apps are like standalone module, which theoretically can be used in other projects. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna create now new app. And in order to do so, let's stop our server and now let's create an app using command Python. manage.py start app, and let's call it home. So this is going to be our home app. So you can see now next to our project we have our home. So in our case we're going to have just a single app. So we have one project and one app. In more advanced or more complicated projects you would have more app, but for the sake of the tutorial we're gonna keep it simple and leave it like that. So now let's go to home and let's check views.py. so this is our first file we're gonna edit. So this is responsible for our views and we're gonna learn more about it in the future. For now let's start and create our very first view. So let's add some new import first. So from Django HTTP import HTTP response. So this is very first thing we're gonna need. And now let's define index request. We'll go into details a little bit later. And let's return HTTP response. And let's say, hello world, you are at home. Okay, now let's save it. Let's add missing colon here. And let's add indents. So what you have to know is that when you code with Python, indents are very, very important. And without them, you will get error like this one. Okay, now let's save it. Now we're gonna create a new file, which is gonna be called urls.py. And this file will define, this will gonna be a matching between an URL. So what we're gonna type in our web browser. So the web browser address, URL of our page with our view, which we just defined. So let's create a new file and let's call it urls.py. And let's type from Django urls import path. That's gonna be, we're gonna use that for parsing our URL patterns. Now let's add from dot import views. So we're gonna import our views and define URL patterns equals path. Views index and name of our view in that case was index. So this relates to name which we defined over here. So this is index, right? Okay, now what we have to do, oh, I have a typo over here by the way. So what we have to do now, so as you know, this is our app. We have to somehow combine or link our project to our app. So within our application, my site, we also have this URLs pie, which you can see already here. And as you can see, we have this URL patterns over there. And this is the place where we have to add our link to our application. So let's add it. I'm gonna add path. And for now, let's call it home. include home URLs. Okay. Let's save it. And now let's run our server again. And we are getting error, which says that name include is not defined. And this is because we didn't include it. So let's do it now from Django conf URLs import include. Now let's save it. And now our server is working fine. And let's try to open this page. So as you can see, it cannot find this path. So this is like an empty path. It says that we have defined two different endpoints. One is admin, which you already seen before, and one is home. So let's see what's going to happen if we try to open home. So this is our page. Now, if we want to make this page available at our root URL address, we have to change this section to empty one, and this will move, this will serve our view immediately after opening our page over here. Okay, now let's do one more thing. So currently within our home app, we have this view which is serving us like direct HTML code. Obviously we could, you know, try to code here something like HTML head body and so on, but this is not the way you want to do it. What you ideally want to do is you want to keep your views in separate folders. So let's create a new folder now and let's call it templates. Now within this folder, let's create a new file and let's call it index.html. Now let's fill this with some data. HTML, some body, and some content word. Okay, now we have to replace this hard-coded HTML with call to our template. Now, in order to do so, we have to do small changes here. So first, we have to define where our template folder is located. So we're gonna set template underscore dirs equals to, and here we're gonna use operating system path join our base dir, so location of this file, and templates folder. So this will tell compiler to search for templates within this folder. Okay, and now let's change this return statement to use different options. So now we use directly HTTP response, and now we're gonna say render request index HTML and let's see if that worked. And as you can see, we are getting error, template does not exist at. And this is because we have to do one more thing, which is we have to register our app in our application settings. So as you remember, my site is our application. So let's go to settings, and here we have installed apps. So we have some pre-installed apps from Django itself. So these apps allows us to, for example, authorize an authenticate, or we can serve static files. And since we want to use our app, home app within our project, we have to add it to the list. So I'm gonna say register or install app called home. Let's save it and let's check now. And now we can see the hello world. Okay, I want to show you one more thing in this part of the tutorial. So I'm going to show you how to pass arguments to our template. So now we have our view over here, and we are passing, we are just calling this template. But now let's learn how to pass some variables, because we're going to use that in the future. So let's go to views and let's import datetime library, and now let's define today equals datetime now date. So this is a variable which will give us today's date, and now let's add this as a parameter to our function call. So we want to pass today, this is the variable name, with the value today. Now we have to parse it in our indexed HTML, and this is very, very simple. In Python, we just say today is today. So we use double brackets and let's check the result. And that's how we passed a variable from our views to our template. Okay, so I hope that was easy. This is like a very extremely and quick getting started to put our hands on Django. And in the next tutorial, I'm going to show you how to connect Bootstrap, how to connect MD Bootstrap to your project so you could start building a real application. So if you don't want to miss the next part of this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn notification on. If you have any questions regarding this tutorial, please don't hesitate to leave a comment down below this video or join our Facebook group where you can also post all the questions which comes to your mind. Thank you very much for watching and see you in the next video.